Hello and welcome to another problem solving session on triangles. In this session we have taken up the problem which is shown on the screen. So what does the question say? The question says a vertical stick of 12 meter long, casts a shadow 8 meter long on the ground. At the same time, a tower casts the shadow 40 meter long on the ground. Determine the height of the tower. Okay, so hence let's try and understand the process of shadow making, right? So let's say this is the sun and or any source of light, and because of that, let's say this is the stick, okay, and this is 12 meter long, and let's say the shadow is 8 meter long. Okay, so let me just name these. So let's say the stick was AB and the shadow is BC. Okay, so given AB is equal to 12 meters and BC, the shadow, is 8 meters. Okay, now there is another tower which is long enough whose shadow, so you know the light rays fall like that and hence the shadow is created, isn't it? The light rays fall on this. And in fact, I should have shown you like this, because the sun will be in that direction from where. So this is the source of light, let's say. Okay, so this is how light is falling on the ground, and hence, right, so sun's position would be somewhere on top. So I'm not showing that. Now similarly, there is a tower, and the tower's, let's say, shadow is this. And let me join these, and this is ABC DEF. Okay, DEF, isn't it? Now this is given to be equal to 40. What is 40? Shadow 40 meter long, so EF is 40 meter long. Okay, so we have to find out what H, correct? Now if you see, this is a very practical problem, and how do we approach it? So clearly the stick as well as the tower is perpendicular to the ground, so this is 90 degrees, and the inclination of the sun will be same, isn't it? At the same time, during the day, the theta angle, whatever the theta angle is, will be the same, because the sun is at the same height for every object, right? So hence, in this case also, the sun rays would be falling like that, and hence the shadow is forming like that, isn't it? So inclination of the sun is somewhere here, let's say, in the horizon. Okay, so hence this is a clear cut question of similar triangle. So if you see in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, what do we get? Angle ABC is equal to angle DEF is equal to 90 degree each, and angle ACB is equal to angle DFE. And why is that? Inclination to sun, both are inclination of sun, correct? Or angle of elevation of sun, whichever way you want to say. Let me write it here now. Therefore triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. And what is that? Reason being, by AA similarity, right? By AA similarity. So this is done. So the moment this is done, I can say AB by DE is equal to BC by EF. Why is that? This is nothing but corresponding parts of similar triangles are proportional, right? So ratio of the sides will be proportional. So now I have to find out DE, isn't it? So DE clearly is equal to AB into EF upon BC. And let's find out the values. So AB is how much? AB was 12 meters into EF. EF is 40 meters divided by BC. BC was 8. Okay, so this is nothing but, this will go 5 times, so it is 60 meters. So you can say the height of the tower is 60 meters. So, you know, now you know how to find out the height of an object. So it is very easy to find a stick with a known length and its shadow. And also you can find the distance between foot of the, let's say, building and a particular point, or let's say the length of the shadow. The moment it is done, you can find out the height of the building, correct, without even trying to climb the building, right? So you don't need to climb the building, and yet you will be able to, or the tower, you will be able to find out the height of the tower, isn't it? So this is so interesting application area of similar triangles.